So once again, welcome to our monthly interfaith meditation with the Marin Interfaith Council. It's a pleasure to have you with us today for our June meditation in 2022. And we're so pleased to have with us Reverend C.J. Dunford, who is assisting minister at the Buddhist Temple of Marin. C.J. is originally from rural southwestern Virginia. Reverend C.J. has lived in the California Bay Area for most of their adult life. They grew up in a very politically and religiously conservative family and Christian church, which made it difficult to reconcile their gender and sexuality with their faith. So they left the church at 18. Several years later, they transitioned to Jōdo Shinshū Buddhism after finding their home temple in Berkeley, where they flourished in the affirming and inclusive Sangha at Berkeley Buddhist Temple. With focus on the role of religion and spirituality as a force of colonization, oppression, and racialization, it's potential for creating supportive, loving community and collective and personal liberation. Reverend C.J. works to develop critical understandings of the intersectional nature of individual and communal identities with an emphasis on queer and trans perspectives, both in their academic work and in their ministry. They hold a deep passion for chaplaincy and spiritual care, mental and physical health, and mutual aid as crucial keys for building equitable and dynamic, thriving communities that can make the world safer and kinder for those who live on the margins of society. So, Reverend C.J., we're so pleased to have you with us today. Thank you so much for leading us, and we'll turn it over to you now.
Thank you, Scott. Thank you, Marin Interfaith Council, for having me, and it's so nice to see so many little faces on my screen. My name is CJ. I use they, them, and theirs pronouns, and I'm participating today from unceded Ohlone land, also known as Berkeley. I'm ordained in the Nishihonganjiha Jōdo Shinshū lineage of Pure Land Buddhism. I serve as a sitting minister at the Buddhist Temple of Marin in Mill Valley and the Berkeley Buddhist Temple. I'm going to be leading us later in a chanting. And normally in a temple, we'd all chant together and we'd hear each other's voices supporting one another, but we're gonna be doing this Marin, Buddhist Temple of Marin Zoom style where I chant and you listen. You can chant at home, but if we all joined together, it would kind of sound terrible because all of our voices would just be cutting in and out. I have a link I'm gonna share in the chat for a PDF of Shōshinge. And so if you want, you can follow along. I encourage you to just try to chant. Don't worry about reading the meaning. There's a translation there, but I encourage you to just chant and see how you feel. We'll talk about it after it's done. I'm grateful to be here today to share practice from my tradition. In the United States and in many other Western countries, Buddhist practice is often thought of simply as mindfulness and/or meditation. While these are essential teachings in Buddhism, like any other religion, Buddhism holds myriad teachings, philosophies, and worldviews and practices as a means to cultivate our spiritual selves. Buddhist practice, very broadly, is a means to train the mind to think about and experience the self beyond our deluded, ego-centered realities. Additionally, Buddhist teachings were transmitted orally and through ritual for the first 500 or so years of its existence after the passing of Shakyamuni, the historical Buddha, in about 500 BCE. Chanting is an important intersection of transmitting the Buddhist teachings, or the Dharma, liturgical practice, and their cultivation in our lived lives. In Jōdo Shinshū Buddhism, our founder Shinran wrote prolifically, and we express our own lineage of practice by reciting the sacred name of Amida Buddha, Namo Amida Butsu. The Shōshinge is a distillation of Shinran's own understanding of the Pure Land Buddhism and our lineage, and the many wasan, often translated as hymns, are poems that exalt the Buddha Amida and Buddha's Pure Land of Sukhavati, and the lineage of masters who allowed us to encounter these transformative teachings. In my own experience of transitioning to Buddhism, I was mystified and confused by the role of chanting at first. After a few temple visits, I would often ponder, What are we chanting and why? Probably the Protestant child in me thinking those things. I was able to read the translations and begin to understand these teachings better. But something really special happens when we just chant in community. In the course of my studies, I learned a lot about Japanese culture and religion, and Jōdo Shinshū Buddhism is a Japanese form of Buddhism. In Japanese culture and religiosity, there's a concept of kotodama, which helped me to understand the metaphysical nature of chanting. Kotodama is a phrase that describes the spiritual power of words and sounds to alter reality. Japanese Buddhist and Kingyan nonviolence educator Kazuhaga shares a story regarding teaching chanting when talking to his teacher. He said that his teacher taught him not to give people the literal definition of the chant. He explained, "When we tell people the meaning of the chant, they focus too much on the literal meaning of the words and stop putting their own prayers into it. The literal meaning doesn't matter. It's the prayer that we put into each chant that matters." So that's how I understand Kotodama, Haga says. It's the spirit that we put into each word that gives it its true meaning. With that in mind, I encourage you to try to chant Shōshinge with me, with our own hopes and aspirations in our hearts, letting go of any attachment to our egos or self-centered desires. Hopefully, you can access the guide that I just shared with the chanting instructions and that it's understandable. But if not, then just listen with an open heart and an open mind and hold those hopes for peace and equity as I chant. I challenge you not to try to read the translation of Shōshinge, though you're welcome to do that later. Rather, just notice what arises as we chant together. I'm going to go sit at a different table and chant, and I'll move my mic over so you can see the image of Amida Buddha.
Gojoku akuji gunjo kai o Manzen jiriki hengon shu,
Enman Tokugo Kansen Sho Sampu Sanshin Keon Gon Zomatsu Hometsu Dohin Isho Zolaku Shiuse Shian Yogai Sho
Namo wa Amida-anbu. Namo Amida-anbu. Namo Amida-anbu. Namo Amida-anbu. Na chie no kohumyo hakari nashi.
Namo Amida-anbu.
Okay, that was our practice of chanting Shōshinge. I hope you found it meaningful, and I can share with you a resource if you want to learn more about Shōshinge and Jōdo Shinshū in general. There's a webpage by the Buddhist Temple of San Diego, which is part of our organization of the Buddhist Churches of America, the overseas district of Nishihonganjiha. Maybe just sit in your chair for a moment, take a deep breath through your nose. Let it out with your mouth. So at the beginning of our services, and throughout the service, we'll put our hands together in gassho. It's an expression of gratitude. Usually we have these beads, they're called lonenju, mindfulness beads. And put them around our palms together like this, and we say the name of Buddha, Namo Amida Butsu. So you probably heard me say that a few times. And usually we'll offer incense in front of the Amida Buddha statue or the name of the Buddha as an expression of gratitude as part of our services too. And I think that's all I had to share for today. And I welcome us into discussion, I suppose, so that we can talk about how that felt for everyone.
Thank you. Thank you so much, CJ. Esmeralda, if you could turn off the recording, please.